Hi guys, welcome to this new series where we'll discuss some interesting questions from the chapter of profit and loss and also work on the shortcuts that we can use in the exams to solve them quickly. Before we proceed further, my name is Prithviraj and I've consistently scored above 99 percentile in multiple exams. I've also cleared SBI PO 2018. So let's start with this question. A shopkeeper sells one book at different prices throughout the week. On Sunday, he sells the book at 10% profit, on Monday at 20% loss, on Tuesday at 30% profit, and so on. If each book costs rupees 145, find the total profit or loss percentage he made in a week. Okay, so first let's try to understand what the question is saying. There's a shopkeeper who sells one book at different prices for different days of the week. So on day one, he would sell it because the cost price is 145 for everyone. So on day 1, he'll say 145 into 11 by 10. On day 2, he'll sell 145 into 8 by 10 because 20% loss. And so on for different days of the week. So what we'll do is we'll find the values of these. These would give us the SP. So what we'll do is we'll calculate all these values. Find the selling price for each day, find the cost price for each day, add them, and then calculate the profit. But this is a time-consuming process. So what we can do is we can use variables instead to make our life easy. So let's assume that the cost price of each book is 100x and not 145, right? So the CP is 100x. On day one, when it's 10% profit, it would be 110x would be the selling price. On day 2, it'll be 80x. Day 3, it would be, since it's 30% profit, so 130x. And now you can see a pattern emerging, right? So on day 4, it'll be 40% loss, so 60x. So now you can see there's a pattern, 110x, 130x, so next would be 150x. 80-60, so next would be 40x, and this would go further, and this would come out to be 170x, and these are all 100x. And now we're done with 7 days, so it becomes a complete week. So these are now easier, much easier to add than if we'd have taken x as 145 and then calculated everything. Since we need to find the profit, we can straight away find this. So these add up to be 700x, and these would also be added easily, and they'll give us some value. But we can also take this one step further. So let's see what it comes out, right? So total CP comes out to be 700x and total SP comes out to be, if you add all these, you'll get 740x, right? So profit becomes 40x. Cost price is 700x. So profit percentage, we'll just multiply this by 100. Cancel this out. This comes out to be 40 by 7%, which would be somewhere around 5.7%. So option C would be the answer. Now, what we've done here, we can also generalize this. So I'm going to rub this and then I'm going to tell you the general formula for such questions. So as a general rule for solving such questions in which, suppose you're given a common cost price for multiple objects, right? Let's say the common cost price for every object is A, right? And then you're given that some objects are sold at X percent, some are sold at Y percent, some are sold at Z percent. So the overall profit or loss percentage is given by X plus Y plus Z, the number of objects, upon n. Now if this is loss, so what would happen is, let's say y percent is actually loss percentage, so it will become x minus y plus z. So what you need to remember is you can straight away add these profit percentages and get to the answer. So I'm gonna write the formula here, profit percent or loss percentage, that depends on the values. I'll show you what I mean exactly, is equal to x plus y plus z for divided by n, that is the number of these percentages that we're taking. So let's try it in this question. Okay, so what we'll do is, for every profit, we'll consider it as positive, but losses would be considered as negative. If the overall value, when you add all these, comes out to be negative, then it's a loss. If the overall value comes out as positive, it's a profit. Okay, so let's try for our question. First would be 10%. Then there's a 20% loss, so this would be minus 20, plus 30, minus 40, plus 50, minus 60, plus 70. And we stop at 70 because there are 7 days in a week. We were supposed to calculate for 1 week. Now, how many are these? These are 7. So we'll divide it by 7. So this would give us the overall profit percentage, and we can calculate out. So 10 plus 30 gives 40. Or we can just do this. 10 minus 20 is minus 10. 30 minus 40 is minus 10. 50 minus 60 is minus 10. So this comes out to be minus 30 plus 70 upon 7. This gives us 40 by 7, which is also what we got by actually solving this question by taking 100x as variable that we had already solved. So the answer would again be 5.7%. So now you can see, if you know this formula, then these kind of questions are very easy to solve. So there are questions where you say there are two objects which have the same cost price, but one is sold at say 10% profit, the other is sold at 25% loss. Find the overall profit percentage or loss percentage. So you can simply do 10 minus 25 upon 2, right? So this comes out to be 15 by 2, 7.5 of negative. So this would mean a 7.5% loss. So such questions can be solved very easily with this shortcut method. This immensely reduces the amount of calculations and the time that you spend on such questions. That's it for this question. Come back with a new question soon. Until then, keep practicing.